Hello, welcome to SS Unitech. Sushil this side, and this is continuation of SSIS tutorial. So today we gonna discuss about OLEDB command transformation. So what is OLEDB command transformation? So the OLEDB command transformation runs SQL statement for each rows in the data flow. For example, we can run an SQL statement that could be inserts, update or delete rows in our database table. And the SQL statement includes parameters. The parameter values are stored in the external column in the transformation input and mapping an input column to an external columns maps an input column to a parameter. So what it mean and how we can use it? So first of all, we want to load data in our database table. Then we want to delete that data. Then we want to update the data. So go to our SSMS. So have a look of source. So this is our source table. Once we execute, then we can see it have two columns. First is ID, then name, and in our destination, it also contains two columns. First is ID and second is name. Initially, we don't have any data. So by using OLEDB command transformation, we want to load data in this table from our source table. So go to on SSDT, and here we gonna add one more package. So right click on this SSIS package, then new SSIS package. After that, I gonna rename this package by OLEDB. Then we have to use a data flow task. So I gonna drag and drop this data flow task and then double click on this data flow task. So here we need to configure our source, transformation and destination. As we have discussed, we have SQL Server table, so we have to use OLEDB source. So we can drag and drop, then double click on this OLEDB source. Here we need to select OLEDB connection manager. So I gonna click on new. Then we have already made the connection. So I gonna click on OK. Here we need to select our source table. So as we have discussed, this is our source table. Go to on columns. So we want ID and name both columns. So we can click on OK. Now we have done our source. Now we have to configure our transformation. And that is OLEDB command transformation. So this is available inside this command. So we can drag and drop this OLEDB command transformation. Then we need to connect with OLEDB source. So here we need to configure our OLEDB command transformation. So now double click on this OLEDB command. In connection manager, we need to select our destination connection manager. So that is our SQL Server table. So we can select. Then go to on component properties. So here we can see we have an option for our SQL statement. So this is our SQL command. Here we can write our SQL statement. So as I have already typed the query, so this is for insert statement. So I gonna copy this and paste in our SQL command. So here we can see we want to insert data in our destination table. So this is our insert statement. Then values coming from parameters. So for that we need to specify question mark. So I have specified two question marks. So first for the ID and second for the name. And then we want to map these parameters from our input source. So I gonna click on OK. Then we need to go on column mappings. So in this column mapping, we can see we have ID and name. So we need to take care about the orders which we have specified in our query. So first is for ID. So parameter 0 should be mapped with ID. Then name should be mapped with parameter 1. So we have done our mapping. Now we need to click on OK. So we have done our OLEDB command transformation. Now we can click on start. As we can see, 8 rows should be inserted in our destination table. So I gonna stop this package and go to on SSMS. Then we can execute our select statement. So as we can see, we are getting the data. This data is inserted in our destination table by row. So our first row will be insert first, then second, then third. So it will be performed row by row. That's why the performance of this OLEDB command transformation is very low. Then we need to configure for delete. So I gonna change our SQL command and this time I gonna use for delete. So this is our delete statement. So I gonna copy this and then we need to paste that command in our SQL command. Then click on OK. Go to on column mappings as we can see ID mapped with parameter 0. So that is fine to me. Now click on OK. And now I gonna execute our package. So this time 8 rows should be deleted from our destination table. Now go to on SQL Server Management Studio. Then we need to execute our select statement for destination table. So as you can see, all rows have gone. So I gonna insert record one more time. So we can copy this insert statement. Go to on OLEDB command. Go to on component properties. Then in SQL command. Now click on OK. Then go to on column mappings. So ID has been mapped successfully. Now we need to map for name. Name is mapped successfully. Now click on OK. Now we can save our package and then we can execute. Once we execute our package, then 8 rows should be inserted in our destination table. Now go to on SSMS. Then we need to execute our select statement. Here we can see we are getting the data. Now this time I wanna update some record manually. So we can update our destination table. Then set, and this time we want to set the value for Shiv Kumar Singh, where ID is equals to 7. Now we can execute our update statement. Now I gonna select. So as you can see, in our ID 7 we are getting Shiv Kumar Singh, but in our source we are getting Shiv only. So once we execute our update statement, then our destination table should be updated. So I gonna copy this update statement, then go to on SSDT. Here we need to double click on this OLEDB command, then component properties, then SQL command. This time insert should be replaced by our update statement. As we can see, name comes first. So we need to map parameter 0 with the name and then parameter 1 with the ID. Now click on OK. Go to on mapping. So name should be mapped with parameter 0 and ID should be mapped with parameter 1. So we can map. Now click on OK. So we have done our package. Now we can save our package and execute. So we can stop this package and go to on SSMS. Then we can execute our select statement for destination table. As you can see, Shiv Kumar Singh has been updated by Shiv. So I hope you have understand how we can use OLEDB command transformation. So it will perform row by row. That's why the performance wise it's not good. Except this, we can use import export or we can use execute SQL task to execute our SQL queries. So thank you so much for watching this video. If you like this video, please subscribe our channel to get many more videos. And don't forget to press the bell icon to get the notification of our newly uploaded videos. Thank you so much.